Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. Do you ever ask anyone about which cryptocurrency exchange is the best? I can bet Bitcoin will be their answer. The financial world cannot stop talking about Bitcoin. Nowadays, the headlines of business diaries and finance sections have covered everything from the importance of investing in Bitcoin to how the bubble is about to burst. So guys, are you a beginner and want to know about Bitcoin? Then you are in the right place. Before moving ahead, welcome to Financial and Investment Wisdom. In this video, we will discuss the Bitcoin Beginner's Guide. So please take a brief moment, go down and touch the like button, and if you have not subscribed to our channel yet, go to subscribe to stay connected. Alright guys, starting from Bitcoin introduction. Bitcoin is an anonymous cryptocurrency introduced in 2009. It is a form of currency that exists digitally through encryption. It had been invented to be unhackable, untraceable, and safe for investors. The value started insanely cheap and hit a bump in 2013 that took about $250 per Bitcoin. Once Bitcoin futures hit the Chicago Mercantile Exchange Group, the price of Bitcoin skyrocketed to nearly $20,000. Think of it this way. If you would invest $100 on January 1st, 2011, when one Bitcoin has valued at 30 cents, those Bitcoins could be worth around $5 million today. Fantastic! So, at least for now, it is not going away. So, here's a quick rundown on what the big Bitcoin is. What is Bitcoin? Bitcoin is a peer-to-peer money protocol designed to operate without central authorities like governments and banks. Its open-source nature guarantees that all its exchanges and Bitcoin's issuance has been secured collectively by genius math, cryptography, and network participants. Such a design makes it the most sophisticated, available, and transparent money. Anybody with the proper skills can take part in this advancement and create a bright future. Now, the question is, how does Bitcoin work? Each Bitcoin trading is a computer file stored in a digital wallet on a computer or smartphone. To understand how Bitcoin cryptocurrency is working, it helps to understand these terms and a little context. Number one is blockchain. Bitcoin is powered by open source code called the blockchain, which makes a shared open ledger. Each exchange is a block that's chained to the code, making a permanent record of each exchange. Blockchain innovation is at the heart of more than 10,000 cryptocurrencies that have followed in Bitcoin's wake. Number two is private and public keys. A Bitcoin wallet contains a private key and a public key, which work together to permit the proprietor to start and digitally sign transactions, providing verification of authorization. And the last and important term is Bitcoin miners. Miners, or individuals of the peer-to-peer platform, then freely confirm the transaction utilizing high-speed computers, normally within 10 to 20 minutes. Miners are paid in Bitcoin for their endeavors. Now, let's discuss the concept of Bitcoin mining. Bitcoin miners, also known as nodes, are the proprietors of high-speed computers which autonomously confirm each exchange and add a completed block of exchanges to the ever-growing chain, which includes a complete public and permanent record of each Bitcoin transaction. This free network of miners also reduces the chance for fraud or wrong information to be recorded, as the majority of miners have to confirm the authenticity of each block of information before it's added to the blockchain, in a process known as proof of work. But does Bitcoin make money? Bitcoin value follows the law of supply and demand. As a result, demand waxes and wanes. There's a lot of instability in the cryptocurrency's price. Besides mining Bitcoin, which needs technically ability and investment in high-performance computers, most people buy Bitcoins as a form of money speculation, betting that the US dollar value of one Bitcoin will be higher in the future than it is nowadays. But that isn't easy to predict. Is Bitcoin infinite? No. At the maximum, the system is planned to top out at 21 million Bitcoin. At that point, Bitcoin will stop being released. Most people think that will be around the year 2140. You see, miners do not build blocks just from the benevolence in their hearts. When a miner makes a block, they moreover have to unravel a series of complex math puzzles. If they can do it before any other miner, they open a predetermined amount of Bitcoin they can keep, a prize for being both clever and speedy. The way this competition for Bitcoin will last until 2140 is through halving events. When Bitcoin is mined, Satoshi Nakamoto released 50 Bitcoin, which he kept, Moving forward, when a miner completes a puzzle, he or she gets 25 Bitcoin. Then, in the summer of 2016, divided that again into 12.5 Bitcoin. That amount will proceed to split periodically until all 21 million Bitcoin have been released. Hold on! Please click the subscribe button to get alarmed for more updates. And do you have any questions so far? Tell us in the comment below. We will respond to you as soon as possible. Now the question is, Bitcoin crypto safe? By the estimation of numerous Bitcoin experts, that public ledger is pretty bulletproof. To alter the catalog, you would not only need to harness a ton of computer power, but you'd also have to do it in a really public space where thousands of other computers and users can see what you're doing. What one individual or computer does influence the entire blockchain, and everybody can police the transactions. So, should you invest? Why? As of now, unless you're investing thousands of dollars in purchasing it in bulk, Bitcoin is nothing more than a stock, though the investors would hate having it explained that way. In time, it could become a reasonable means of purchasing goods and services. Japan acknowledges it now, legally. But for now, it is truly an investment. And in case you're smart or lucky, it can make you money, expecting the bubble doesn't burst. But how do I invest? Similar to any investment, it's best to refer to somebody well-versed in making investments. But a great rule isn't to invest any more than you're willing to lose. Cryptocurrency can be unstable, developing and plummeting in terms of value each day. If you are still interested, you can download a few apps on your mobile phone to get started investing, like Blockfolio, Coinbase, and Bitstamp. These apps are also computerized wallets that store your Bitcoin. The most helpful and famous seems to be Coinbase. You can download an app on your phone and invest up to $750 a week. It's secure, but again, it gathered few buzzy features last for insider exchanging. Buying Bitcoin. Nothing in the world is ideal. Everything has some benefits as well as some drawbacks. Similarly, Bitcoin is also not a perfect currency. Now, let's discuss some pros and cons of Bitcoin cryptocurrency. With a speculative asset class like Bitcoin, it's better to begin with all pros and cons you should be aware of. Firstly, we will discuss the pros. Bitcoin is a private, secure exchange anytime with less potential fees. Once you possess Bitcoins, you can exchange them anytime, anyplace, reducing any transaction time and cost. In addition, trades do not contain personal data like name or credit card number, eliminating the risk of stolen consumer data for fraudulent purchases or identity theft. Keep in mind that to buy Bitcoins on a trade, generally, you'll first need to link your bank account. It has the potential for enormous growth. A few investors who purchase and hold the currency are wagering that once Bitcoin matures, greater belief and more far-reaching use will follow, and thus Bitcoin's value will grow. In addition, after the financial crisis and the incredible recession, a few investors are enthusiastic to grasp an alternative, decentralized currency, one that's essentially outside the control of traditional banks, governing authorities, or other third parties. However, to purchase Bitcoin and trade with US dollars, you'll likely need to link your bank account. Now, let's see some drawbacks of Bitcoin. The first con of Bitcoin is its price instability. The 2017 spike in Bitcoin's cost was driven by speculators surging into the Bitcoin market, as NerdWallet staff writers discussed at the time. As a result, the recent gains are great news if you bought Bitcoin in December 2018. Those who purchased in 2017, when Bitcoin's cost was dashing toward $20,000, had to wait until December 2020 to recuperate their losses. The second con is hacking concerns of Bitcoin. Where supporters say the blockchain innovation behind Bitcoin is more secure than conventional electronic cash exchanges, Bitcoin hot wallets have been an attractive target for hackers. There have been a few high-profile hacks, such as the news in May 2019. Hackers stole more than $40 million in Bitcoin from a few high-net-worth accounts on cryptocurrency trade Binance. Then the company covered the losses. No doubt Bitcoin is a highly speculative and volatile purchase. It's worth remembering that stock exchanging can give you a comparative thrill. We've covered a lot of ground about Bitcoin, but I have to warn you, most people who begin trading Bitcoin stop after a short while, mainly because they don't effectively make any money. Here is my opinion. If you want to be effective at exchanging, you will have to put in a significant amount of money and time to acquire the relevant skills similar to any other venture. If you need to get into trading to make a speedy buck, then maybe it's a better way to avoid exchanging altogether. There is no such thing as quick, easy money without a chance or drawback at the other end. So guys, summarizing today's video, no doubt Bitcoin is an incredibly speculative and volatile buy. Do you have any questions regarding Bitcoin? Do not hesitate to add your thoughts in the comment section. If you have not subscribed to our channel yet, then subscribe and hit the notification button to get alarmed with our latest content. If you want to make money and enjoy financial freedom, then financial and investment wisdom is for you. Thanks for your time. Be happy.